All right, guys, this is the last carpet stretch of the week. I don't even know what to say. Dear Lord, I apologize. It must have been all the fun I had in high school and college that I'm paying for now. This is not what you're looking for as an end of the week stretch. This is like a Monday morning when you're fresh and you know you've got some energy in you. Not the end of the week thing at all. I'm going to turn the camera around and I'm going to show you what I'm getting ready to try to do. And naturally, before I leave, I'll have it right. But who knows what I'll have to go through to get it right. Which is why I just pray a little bit before I start this thing. Here we go. Let me show you. This is the setup here. We got the world's heaviest bed. Comes in at just over a ton. We got that guy, which is a ton. We got wrinkles that are here. The camera's gonna flatten it out, but that's a really big wrinkle here, what it is. And then this is not your friend either, because we're gonna have to go this way. So that's a problem right there. Now, how is a guy, without taking that off the wall, without moving the bed, how do you get it to stretch back at least maybe this far? Because the carpet itself is extremely thick. I can tell that by without even putting the awl through it yet, until it's really thick. And over here, I've got some more issues, which kind of start off in here. So that means I'll probably have to go multiple directions, which is a good time. Always is. This guy here, it's in the way, weighs a ton. Over here, you can see him mainly from over here, but basically right in here, we've got wrinkles. So, we're not done. Look at this. So when you come up the stairs and you turn the corner and you look in here, it's when your heart kind of drops. Like, oh God, oh my Lord, how am I gonna make this happen? You know, and in typical form, I would have to say, I don't know. I'll tell you when I finish. This guy, what I offered in here is basically that the edges kind of there are bothering me a little. So what I said is, how about I take it up along here and I stretch it in a little bit. We call that good, because we're not going to do a wall-to-wall stretch on an island closet, you know, on an island right in the middle of the closet. It's not going to happen. So that's what we've offered here. You see, that's a little bit of an issue there. Not a huge one. We've already had all our preliminary talks about this, and we're on the same page, at least I feel like. So what I'm gonna do to begin with is take it up along that wall while I pray and put the hooks in it with these little guys and pull it across a little bit. And then with my super duper Triforce stretcher here, do a little praying and a little pushing, and hopefully get that. I'm not gonna take that off. I'm not. I may have to, but initially I'm not. Because, you know, if you do carpet, you know why. If not, I guess I could tell you, you know, this is gonna come off of there, and then I've gotta find another piece, which whatever I cut off here is not going to suffice to be able to patch it in there and make it look like nothing ever happened. That's where we're at with that. All right. Around here, it's going to have to go two directions. All right, I'm going to shut up now and get to work and hope something favorable starts happening pretty quick. Otherwise, I don't know. I might run crying. This is too fancy for this time of day. But here we go. See you in the next clip. Alrighty, Figured I would show the thickness of the carpet here, because if you saw the one I did yesterday, this one is going to be like trying to stretch like a cotton canvas or something. It's just it's not going to want to stretch. The stretcher is going to pop and clink and crackle and do everything but break, and it may break. You never know. And I went ahead and took it up across there, and not there, and that goes beyond reason why. But I've seen dumber things work out, so you know, I give it a shot. I'm not afraid. I'm not chicken. All right, checking back out again. All right, I'm trying to not forget to vlog. I've been posting pictures of this on the Carpet Muscle TV Facebook group. So basically the way it's going here, and this is a vlog, this is not a how-to, and I'm not showing any of the stretching because it's really difficult. But basically the stretcher's cracking and popping, and it feels like it's just about to give way trying to stretch this ultra thick carpet. The cotton teeth on this guy, it's weird, different than other carpet, but it actually pushes back about a half an inch, and then it stops and it sticks and it doesn't move, and it barely even picks up the carpet on the back side of it. But when you first get on the power stretcher to start using it, it feels like the back feet aren't going to grip. But as soon, because I guess the fibers are probably like that long or so, I mean they're really long, so those fibers have to travel a long way before they quit pulling. I think the carpet is, yeah, that's why the carpet is going this way, so they have to move, you know, this far back before they stop. So it's all kind of different stuff I haven't dealt with before. It's rare you find a carpet that's this thick. I've done it before, but never with this particular issue. Heavy furniture and in the way stuff. So yeah, the next thing after I get done here with this little bit, gonna have to move this guy. So we're gonna put skidders under it, and probably I'll put a lifting strap under the feet, and I'll pull while the gentleman pushes, and we'll take it right under there. Thank goodness that's it's a big house. Really big. Wonderful, beautiful. There's deer out there, there's deer out back. I don't know if you can see them or not, but there's, yeah, you can see them walking back there if you watch. But it's a creek behind the house. It's super nice. There's plenty to look at out the window. Anyway, back to stretching my go. All right, got a little prettying up to do, a little tucking in stuff here still. This guy got it stretched on this side. However, we're gonna have to move this guy next. So we'll see this in the next frame. We'll be over here. All right, I believe when I was up there last, we were here. Now, drug this guy out of the way, and I think I've showed it in other videos. This guy here, this is the strap I used to pull the furniture with. So with me pulling on the strap and the gentleman pushing on it, we got it over there. So I got this guy all pulled up along here. So I'm gonna stretch everything this way. Should be able to pull all of this out of there, but I don't feel like I need to put nails in it, because it's as difficult as it is to stretch. I don't feel like I'm just gonna have that big of an issue with it trying to pull up here. So I should be able to get everything, I think everything to about right here, which should work just fine. I'm thinking. Real nice couple. They ordered pizza and had me come down and have dinner with them. So that's very, very pleasant. Very much appreciated. All right, I'm gonna grab the Triforce here, and I'm gonna get started in this area right here, and I will be back to check in here and show what I've done here in a minute. Hopefully something silly won't happen, like the handle won't break off it or something. You never know. All right. Not getting getting a really good amount of stretch out of it. It's very, very difficult this other way for some reason. But over here, where you've got significant wear on the carpet, footsteps, it's softer, and you can stretch it more. So you can see kind of what's going to come off both there and in the doorway. If the carpet was thinner, I wouldn't have to cut any of that off. It would just tuck in. Over here, what I'm still have to, I have a couple things. Well, this, you know, I've got the little cutouts that are going to be, could be an issue. And the fact that I've got to pull all the way back to there to try to get this to pull out of there. I'm trying to see if I can make that pull out. And at the same time, I've got a seam right here that, I don't know if I can show. It's right here. I've got to hope that the seam can take the stretch. If not, then you have to use special language with it and then start over. You have to make the seam again. You'd have to regather yourself if you pull the seam apart, because that is no picnic at about 7:45 on a Saturday afternoon. So, it's a little late, but the one thing I can say is the people that I'm working for being an incredible, incredible host. Couldn't be nicer people. Couldn't be. All right, I'm going to move this guy kind of out of the way somewhere, either one side or the other, and then sneak in there with my Triforce over here and snug this guy up as much as I can. Wish me luck. Out here, I am finished, but let me show you what I found in here. Basically, I was going to look around at this and see what could be done, and turns out, like both there and then places like this over here, this was the way it goes. It looks like it's wrinkled, and it kind of is, but when you pull it up and look at it, I don't know if you can tell, but yeah, you see it a little bubbled feeling. What's going on is the tack strip is fairly far away from the wall. Like over here, I dug this guy up, and the tack strip is like, it's like back here. So when the carpet goes beyond the tack strip, you go to tuck it in. I tried to tuck it in high and not push it all the way down, because when you push it all the way down, it goes in a slope like this. So no matter what you do, when you get to the wall, you're gonna have a roll. So this closet, you know, at this hour, there's not all I can do. It would be an all-day project for minimal, you know, minimal good you could get out of it, because I would have to move all the tack strips, you know, pull all the carpet back, put the tack strips a little closer to it, then stretch it and tuck it in. And for what you get, it's really not worth all the trouble you have to go through to get it. Same with right there. It's technically not that loose in here. Got to get the vacuum and vacuum all of this up. It stretched easier over here than it did over here. I wasn't able, for the same reason, to get this guy to work with me too much. I pulled this up and found pretty much the same thing under there, but this is what I got off of here. stretching that area. And over here, I couldn't get that much of a stretch out of it. It just wasn't that far to go. And then over here, where it was heavier traffic, you know, this is what I got off of. I think this is from maybe there, and this is from, it didn't really matter which one's which, but anyway, right there and right there, that's where that's from. And all of this junk here is from right there. So it's kind of where we're at. We're at a stopping place. So I'm going to get the vacuum and clean up and help the gentleman put his big giant cabinet, whatever that is, back over here. All right, guys, appreciate you watching. That was a difficult stretch at a late hour, but for really, really, really good people. So, you know, my wife's sitting at home. It's about 8 o'clock at night on a Saturday night, and I'm still out working. But my wife is wonderful, and these clients are wonderful, so we're all good, you know. There was a time when I couldn't work this late without getting in trouble because of who I was married to, so a lot of blessings going on in my life. Anyway, so thank you guys for watching, and if you have questions, you're always welcome to reach out to me. 512-350-1129, that's the number. If you have questions about if you want to stretch your carpet, I have people call me up, you know, that were trying to do home projects, you know, and call me and go, hey, man, I saw your video. How do I do this? You know, and then you talk to them a little while and you realize that they're not a carpet guy. They're an individual trying to figure out what to do. So I give them the best advice I can to help them. So everything I can do to get kind of staying in the right direction here. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. I will see you next week. This is the last job of this week. See you Monday. Taking tomorrow off. Tomorrow's Sunday.